Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jayanthi Ravindran, and today let's talk about certain common myths among our clients when they come for hair transplant surgery. Hair transplant controls hair loss. That is wrong. Hair transplant does not control hair loss. Hair transplant is a solution for established areas of baldness. It does not control further hair loss. So if someone presents with early stage of baldness, like grade 3 Norwood scale, once they do hair transplant, they do not need to take any further medication. That belief is wrong. Hair transplant can restore hair in areas where you have already lost hair, but cannot control hair loss. To control hair loss, you need to take medication, and PRP can help to some extent. PRP is a permanent treatment for advanced stages of baldness, or it's a permanent solution to control hair loss. This is a myth, and this statement is wrong. PRP is not a permanent solution to control either hair loss or to restore the hair completely after advanced stages of male pattern or female pattern baldness. PRP can temporarily block 5-alpha reductase activity based on scientific research, and it provides growth factors to push hairs that are in the sleeping phase to the growth phase. Thereby, they improve the quality of hair and they restore hair in the sleeping phase to come back to the anagen phase. They cannot permanently bring back hair in areas of established baldness. People think if they take one cycle of PRP, the hair restored is permanent for the rest of their life. This is a myth. PRP has to be repeated requirement of the client in terms of excessive hair loss or sudden shock loss or areas or in times when there are conditions which are precipitating excessive hair loss. It is not a permanent solution. Hair transplant is a treatment for all types of baldness or alopecia or hair loss. This is a myth and this is wrong. Hair transplant is a good treatment option for male pattern hair loss. There are many patients who come with diffuse unpatterned alopecia, which is also male androgenic alopecia, this is not the best treatment option in an active stage of alopecia areata, where it could be patchy loss or it could be a diffuse loss. Sometimes if a scalp biopsy is not done, we assume a diffuse alopecia areata, or we call it alopecia areata incognita. We confuse that with androgenic alopecia, and even if hair transplant is done, the results are not successful. So in such conditions, scalp biopsy is mandatory, and thus hair transplant is not a treatment solution for all types of baldness. Hair transplant cannot be done for ladies. This is a myth and that's wrong. Hair transplant can be done in ladies for established female pattern hair loss if the donor area is good and if there are no other comorbid conditions. However, female clients, a scalp biopsy would tell us the condition of the scalp before we proceed with hair transplant. Hair transplant can give good results in terms of restoring hairline in female patients and established female pattern baldness. 7,000, 8,000 grafts can be harvested per session from a scalp. This is wrong and that's a myth. Based on established, published scientific data, it is very evident that if FUE is done, if the grafts are harvested from a safe zone, so the donor area can be divided into a safe zone, a standard zone, and an extended zone. A safe zone from the back of the scalp in an advanced stage of baldness can only yield about 3000 to 3500 grafts or follicular unit. And if this zone is extended to the standard zone, another 1000 grafts could be harvested. And if this is extended beyond this standard zone to the extended zone, another 1000 to 1500 grafts can be harvested. However, so when you visit a clinic for hair transplant, please differentiate whether the surgeon or the practice manager is referring to individual hairs or follicles or follicular units or grafts. In a single session, the international recommendation is to transplant anywhere between 3,500 to 4,000 grafts in order to limit, not to compromise the donor area in terms of vascular necrosis and other shock loss kind of side effects. Results of hair transplant could mimic a wig or a hair piece. This is a myth and this is wrong. As baldness proceeds, there is gradual loss of hair from the scalp. Normal scalp, each square centimeter contains about 70 to 90 hair follicles. When we do hair transplant, in general, we replace around 30 to 50 follicular units per square centimeter. Depending on the thickness of the grafts and the availability of the donor hair and the stage at which the patient is presenting for replacement. Thus, if someone assumes that after presenting with an advanced stage of baldness, we can do hair transplant and mimic a result just like a wig or a hair piece, it's impossible and that's a myth.